Hey, what's up guys, it's Dr. D here, and today we are going to talk about whether low potassium really causes diabetes.
Diabetes and potassium are interesting topic, but why you have decided to talk particularly about this topic?
I don't want to attack anyone personally, but seeing these YouTube gurus claiming that low potassium causes diabetes really gets my blood boiling. As someone with background in nutrition, herbal medicine and Western medicine, I'm really believing in holistic approach to managing medical condition. However, I can't endorse claims that lack scientific basis. Unfortunately, there are some people that profit from picking out rare correlations and presenting them as causations.
Just because there may be links between potassium and diabetes, for example, it doesn't mean that a deficiency in potassium automatically causes diabetes.
Like this are taken out of context and serve only one purpose, to distract us from the real issue.
It's frustrating to see these types of videos and articles circulating because they misinform the public and ultimately they do more harm than good.
So why don't you believe that low potassium is a major risk factor for diabetes?
First thing first, believing these claims is like sitting in a room with a huge elephant in the middle but completely ignoring it. It's just not accurate. Diabetes is a metabolic disorder which is characterized by high blood sugar levels due to lack of insulin production or the body's inability to use insulin effectively.
While low potassium levels can cause a range of symptoms like muscle weakness, fatigue, and irregular heartbeats, it is not a known cause of diabetes. What these gurus are referring to is the result of several studies that suggest that increasing potassium intake may help to improve insulin sensitivity and lower the risk of developing type 2 diabetes, which is correct, but that is not only because potassium by itself.
Because potassium is found in foods like fruits, vegetables and legumes, which by themselves can help improve overall quality of someone's diet by substituting them for junk food which is loaded with sugar and promoting healthy weight, which are the most important factors in preventing diabetes.
In fact, a holistic approach is needed to manage any medical condition, and diabetes is not exception.
Diabetes is a complex disease that involves a combination of genetics, environmental and lifestyle factors.
So what are the main causes for diabetes? There are many reasons why someone can develop diabetes, but today let's focus on the four most significant ones. First up, obesity. Each 5 kg increase in body weight has been associated with a 31% increased risk of type 2 diabetes. That's a huge number. Secondly, sedentary lifestyle is another significant risk factor for type 2 diabetes.
Physical inactivity leads to decreased insulin sensitivity and impaired glucose metabolism. Each 2.5 hour per week increase in moderate intensity physical activity was associated with a 9% lower risk of developing type 2 diabetes.
An unhealthy diet high in refined carbohydrates, added sugars and saturated fats can increase the risk of developing type 2 diabetes.
Each additional daily serving of sugar-sweetened beverages was associated with a 13% higher risk of developing type 2 diabetes. These numbers are huge.
Genetics also play a role. Certain genetic variants can increase the risk of developing type 2 diabetes.
However, lifestyle factors such as diet and physical activity still play a more significant role in developing type 2 diabetes than genetics.
How would you like people to look at the genetic risk that can make them more prone to certain diseases, such as diabetes?
Think of genetics like carrying a loaded gun. Just because you possess the genetic predispositions for a disease, it doesn't mean that the genes will automatically trigger it. You still have a significant amount of control over your genetic risk. It's like having a loaded gun in your pocket. You have the choice not to pull the trigger. So don't use your genes as an excuse for giving up.
Yes, fighting genetic risks may require more effort, but it's still possible to overcome them. Don't let the fear of genetics hold you back. You have the power to take control of your health and well-being.
So there you have it guys, low potassium does not cause diabetes, but a combination of genetic, environmental and lifestyle factors do. Remember to take care of your body by exercising regularly, eating a healthy diet and maintaining a healthy weight. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, give us thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more health related content. See you in our next video.